Well, here we are on the middle lake at Gold Valley for this month's e-magazine, and today I'm going to cover a couple of different methods that really have come to the fore on the commercials just lately. One of them is fishing pellets shallow and turning the rig over all the time, using the hook bait or the pellet that's on the hair to make a lot of noise and trying to catch odd fish like this. It's a method that's accounted for a lot of fish at Cudmore in the Fishermania. Although we fish with worms, this is how we fish. The day before, there were some big weights in the Fishermania final itself, fishing pellets like this. So I'm going to go a little bit into depth with this method and show you exactly how I go about doing it with the loose feeding and turning the rig over, getting into a rhythm. It's very much like pellet waggler fishing, you'll find. The people that work the hardest will normally catch the most fish. The people that turn the rig over the most will catch the most, feed the most often. The person that works the hardest, like I say, normally gets the most rewards. The second one, in previous e-magazines, we have looked at edge fishing quite a lot, and it's always been very aggressive, either with ground bait, meat, corn, ground bait and maggots. And one thing that I've noticed on a lot of commercials, and you may well have done too, is the fact that these carp are starting to shy away from big amounts of bait. Don't get me wrong, on a lot of commercials it's still working, but on some and on certain days they shine away. So today I'm going to be fishing with meat and a tiny bit of krill ground bait down the edge. I'm going to throw a few bits in and just look for swirls later on in the session, and then when I go on it, a little pot, 20 bits of meat and a tiny dusting of ground bait, and just see if I can catch them like this. Here at Gold Valley, a lot of people have been piling baiting and it has been working, but in the last 2 or 3 weeks, the people that have been taking it more steady have definitely caught more fish. The meat I'm using today has been soaked in a krill liquid overnight, which again, because we're not introducing a lot of bait, the bait that I want to introduce needs to be very powerful to hold these fish in my peg. Hence the flavouring, hence the strong krill ground bait. So that's the two methods that I'm going to be looking at in this month's e-magazine. Now I'm going to show you the tackle that I'll be using. I'm now going to run through the gear I'm going to be using in today's session, starting with the shallow rig. And it is a little bit different for when you're rotating, you're swinging it around all the time, using the pellet, the 8mm pellet that's going to be on the hair as a splash, and that's what you're looking for. Very much like when you're pellet waggler fishing, you're looking to catch them off the splash of the float. Today we're looking to catch them off the splash of the pellet. Although I will be loose feeding a few 6mm as well, just to get some fish in the area, it really is the splash of the pellet being rotated all the time that is going to attract these fish. 018 line straight through, again nice and heavy. A size 12 gamma G point, again we've spoke about this hook, but it is a very small size 12. And you'll notice I've got a dibber there with a wire stem. The Drennan dibbers are definitely my favourites. This one's a Mick Wilkinson. And the only reason I use this is because of the metal stem. It gives a little bit more weight in the float for when you're turning the float over. It's much easier. A carbon stem, it doesn't give you this, and you end up having to use a bigger float, which again defeats the object. Two shot right under the float, so it's a nice free line. So when that pellet hits the water and I decide 1, 2, 3 and leave it, you get a nice natural fall. And most of the bites will come within seconds. White hydro on a puller kit, again, these fish when they're hooked shallow can really shoot off quick. So you want a nice soft elastic, just let them go out, ship back nice and slow and play them on the puller kit. So that's the shallow rig. Going on to the edge rig, again, very much like we've used in the past, 020, a size 14 hook this time instead of a size 12. We're not using a big bunch of maggots or double corn or worms this time. We're using a single bit of meat, again, to tame these fish that are a little bit wary, that have clued themselves up to this big amount of ground bait and worms coming in. Fish dead depth, about half an inch over depth. Again, same old float, Casey Angling rock, and again, red hydro. This is in a CTK5, so I've fitted it with a puller bung. Again, even though red hydro is very strong, some of these big margin fish can really take some getting in. So to just recap, the shallow rig, I'm going to be loose feeding 6mm pellets at 14.5 metres and really working hard. You'll see later what I mean by the person that works the hardest quite often gets the most rewards. In the edge, I'm going to start with literally quarter of a pot of a krill ground bait and quarter of a pot of meat, and then I'm just going to throw in 6 or 7 bits of meat religiously all the time and then go from there. And when I go on it, I'm going to be potting in small bits of meat with a tiny bit of ground bait. So that's the tactics and the rigs looked at. I'm now going to show you the bait that I've got for today's session. I'm now going to run through the baits I've got today, starting with the ground bait. It's the old Ghost krill ground bait. It's mixed quite dry because when I start introducing it in the cup with some meat, I'm literally going to put just a dusting over the top, not in a ball, just a little dusting of ground bait. And like I've said, when you're introducing small amounts of baits on these commercials in the warmer months, the bait that you introduce does need to be powerful. Although there's not a lot of bait there, they're not spooking away, the power of the bait is very, very important. And by this, I mean the richness of the flavours and the ingredients. So the old Ghost krill is my number one choice for when I'm fishing negative in the edge. Going on to hook bait, another bait that I'm going to be feeding in the edge, is luncheon meat. Just normal plum rose luncheon meat with a little bit of a twist. Again, this has been soaked overnight in old Ghost krill liquid. Again, cut up, put into a bag, the liquid's poured in, and then just tied tight and left in the fridge. And the reason I use this, I'm not a great lover of additives, but the old Ghost krill additive really goes hand in hand with the meat. And thinking along the lines of not introducing much, but it needs to be powerful, you get a nice oily slick coming off of this, which I'm sure definitely attracts more fish. The luncheon meat's very oily, but like I say, what's good about the krill liquid is it goes hand in hand. The luncheon meat still smells of luncheon meat. It's got that meaty sort of fishy smell now, and it really is a fantastic combination to go with the luncheon meat. And I have caught a lot of fish fishing negative like this. Now going on to fishing shallow, just the normal 6mm fishery pellets here. They've not been soaked. I don't want them to sink fast. If an odd one floats, that's not a problem because we're looking to catch these fish shallow. But 6mm, and I'm looking to get the peg fizzing, getting fish in my peg with these, and then by rotating the rig, using that 8mm pellet as an attractor and a hook bait, then catch the fish that are just cruising around on the surface. So, for the obvious reasons, I've got some 8mm pellets here just for the hair. If the wind were to get up, I would consider feeding these, but 6mm is definitely my number one choice. So, all in all, it's going to be a negative session down the edge, looking to catch late. Just throwing in meat all the time, completely different to any edge fishing that we've done before in the e-magazine. And then long, again, we're looking to rotate the rig and catch fish by using the hook bait. Again, we fished shallow a lot before, but not like this. And not just here at Gold Valley, but a lot of commercials throughout the country, this really is the way to fish, not just shallow, but in the edge as well. I've shown you the tackle and the bait. I really am itching to start. So let's have a go and see if we can put these tactics to good use. I've just fed my inside line, like I say, a dusting of ground bait and a bit of meat. And I'm just going to be throwing in five or six bits of meat like this all the time. And hopefully later on in the session, the last couple of hours, if I see a swirl, I'm going to go down there. I've already got my little pot ready for about 15, 20 bits of meat and a dusting of ground bait just to be poured in to catch these wary fish. Now you can see I've got the shallow rig, so I'm going to start like this. I've loose fed a couple of times, not seen any swells, but there is a few bubbles, which is always a good sign. And this rig is just going to be flicked over using the 8mm pellet as an attractor, using the noise of the 8mm pellet as an attractor. So like I say, we're going to be fishing 14.5 metres, nice and comfortable, ship the rig out. And then I'm just going to start by just turning the rig over. It always takes a few minutes just to get into the swing of things, into the rhythm, and just using that 8mm pellet, it really has got some momentum when you're flicking it over, especially when the float's got a wire stem, which again adds weight. It's nice and easy, and normally 3 or 4 or 5 times, and then on the 4th or 5th time, just leave it and see. There was a swell there then, which is a fantastic sign that the fish are coming to this bit of noise. Sometimes I'll only flick it over a couple of times if there's a fish in the area. There you go. And again, like I say, as with all shallow fishing, loose feeding, creating that area of bait. But you'll notice straight away how hard I'm working, how often I'm flicking the rig over. I'm trying to make as much noise as possible with that hook bait and looking for a real fast bite virtually within seconds of the pellet hitting the water. So what you're trying to do is going plop, 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 plop with the pellet and the carp are coming to that noise, and then on the, like I say, the fourth or fifth time you leave it, and that's when you've got your hook bait right where that, all that noise has been created. And that's why rotating can be such a deadly method, not just here at Gold Valley, but on a lot of other commercials throughout the country. It's very rarely on this you actually miss bites. There you go, there's a fish there. Literally 2 or 3 seconds after rotating that rig, just literally went to pick my catapult up, the float went under and I lifted and the elastic's out. And that fish has come to the noise of that pellet being flicked over, flicked over, flicked over, flicked over. The carp's almost waiting, and it, some of them must be thinking to themselves, well, where's the bait, because the noise is here. And then on the fourth or fifth time, you actually relax and let your hook bait fall into the water. And that's when the carp are ready and waiting. And that's why this method can be, like I say, so deadly. This one's pulling a little bit. Could be one of the decent fish. But like I say, especially on venues where there's a good head of F1s and smaller carp, this really can be a fantastic way of catching fish. You're not feeding lots and lots of bait because you're using your hook bait almost as an attractor. You do need to feed some, obviously. There you go. One thing you will see me do through the session is just checking my pole sections as I'm coming in and out. And the reason for this, again, is quite simple. When you're rotating and you're using your pole a lot, flicking, 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 you can wear some of the joints a little bit loose. So like I say, when you're targeting carp that could quite easily pull the sections apart, it's always just good to be mindful of the fact that this can happen. No matter what make of pole you use, the joints can just wear loose. And it's just an idea to check them on your way in and on your way out. Not all the time. Every fish, every other fish, every other ship out. That way you can avoid any accidents with losing tops of your pole. You can see the white hydro's working nice. That fish really shot off at a rate of knots, but everything's under control now. Not the biggest fish in the lake, but again, a fantastic start on a method that's designed to just catch those odd fish. You saw in one of the last issues of the E-magazine when we were dobbing, when the fish are actually visible. This is for those days when it's slightly colder. The fish aren't visible, but they're still up in those surface areas. And by making that noise, you can definitely put a fair few fish together. It looks like a nice common carp right down by my keep net. There we go. He's ours. What a fantastic start to the session. Probably around about 5 pound. Maybe a little bit more, but again, you can see this carp has been swimming around and it's heard the noise of those pellets and it just can't resist it. And it's been waiting, waiting, waiting. After 4 or 5 rotations, we've let the rig go and it's been there. And literally after 2 or 3 seconds, the float was under and we were into our first fish of the session. So like I say, as with all shallow fishing, another hook bait on. Pole together and immediately I'm getting into the routine of just throwing in half a dozen bits of meat 2 or 3 times, being mindful of the fact I don't want to pile baiting. What I'm trying to do is avoid building a massive area of bait, because at the moment, like we say, on some venues that's what they're shying away from. So always being mindful of what you're trying to do. I don't want to go throwing in handfuls of bait when I'm trying to fish my match a negative way. There you go, I've just loose fed, rotated the rig 4 or 5 times and relaxed. Loose feed again and then repeat the process. As we've done with the pellet waggler fishing, and as you've seen, the people that work hard, the people that feed and cast and are in and out and really working, getting their float to land, normally are the people that do well and catch more. And when you're fishing like this shallow on the pole, it's no different. In fact, it's exactly the same. I've watched quite a few matches, watched the Fishermania final, and that was no different. The people that were working the hardest were getting the most bites. And if you can get the most bites and get those fish in, obviously you're going to take a lot of beating. Well, we've been fishing shallow now for about 2.5 hours. We've had 12 or 13 reasonable carp, no real big ones, one about 8 or 9 pound and a few small ones, but it really has been a fantastic exercise. All the time I've been throwing in 6 to 10 bits of meat down the edge with the soaked krill liquid, and I have just seen a swell. It's still quite early in the day, but I think it's worth now, having fished long for a good bit and caught a number of fish, to have a go down the edge. But I think you'll see what I meant by work rate when you're fishing shallow. You need to keep turning the rig over, keep feeding, but also be mindful of the fact that you need to keep your other lines topped up. You can't just start these lines, you can't neglect them at all. You need to keep them fed, because at any time, one line can die and you do need to switch. The long line, if anything, was getting better, but I do think now it's time to put the cup on the edge rig and have a go down the edge. Just because we're fishing and feeding in a negative way, it doesn't mean that we're not fishing for a big weight of fish. If you can catch a fish every single cast after potting in a few bits of meat, you're going to end up with a big weight. Considering we've had a dozen or 13 fish shallow already, we're well on the way to a decent weight. But like I say, I feel we've spent long enough shallow and now it's time to have a go, negative feeding down the edge, but still fishing for a decent weight of fish. There you go, there's one down the edge. It's our second one down the edge, and there has been all of a sudden an odd sign. I've missed a bite, there's been another swirl, so it's a good sign. It's still reasonably early in the day, but the good thing is, when you're fishing, not necessarily fishing, but feeding negative in the edge, is that it's very rarely you get a lot of fish in your peg and not be able to catch them. Normally, as one comes in your peg, you'll catch it, just purely because of the lack of bait that you've got in your peg. But there, also in the same breath though, you do need to be mindful of the fact that once that bait's gone, there's not going to be anything there. And although we're being negative and not feeding much, you need to keep something in the water all the time. Which is why you'll see now, I'll just throw, not a lot, just 4, 5, 6 pieces of meat. I won't do it again, just something there now, just to keep any fish that are in the area interested, just so that I've got something. Like I say, I don't want a pile of bait, because I know at the moment the fish are just shying away from that. There you go, it's a nice mirror carp. Decent fish, probably 7 pound. Well, here we are, we've had 6 or 7 fish down the edge, just feeding nice and negative, and I really feel like I'm on top of the peg. There's not too many fish, and when one comes in, I tend to hook it. I've lost 2, but this does happen. One was in the mouth, just pulled off. One was foul hooked. But these sort of things do happen. But the good thing when you're feeding it negative is that when the fish come in your peg, you do hook them. You don't get lots of signs, lots of swirls, lots of missed bites like you do when you're feeding really positive. The only other thing that you've got to keep on top of is obviously having bait there. It's okay feeding negative, but you do always need bait there, which is why I'm feeding regular, which is why you see me when I've played a fish for a while, just throw in 6 or 8 bits of meat just to keep something there. You've got to be very careful that you're not too negative and end up with no fish in your peg. But like I say, we're not getting millions of indications, but when we do get one, it's a reasonable fish. I've had a couple of fish around about 9 or 10 pound, nothing massive. But again, we're well on the way to building a very good weight. And I'm really happy. Sometimes when you're fishing in the edge and you're feeding positive, you can tend to lose track and not be that happy with the way things are going. Feeding it like we fed it today, I'm on top of the peg and I feel really happy, like I know exactly what's going on. I'm not going to get in a mess, I'm not going to start losing lots. And like I say, if this was a match at the moment, I'd be more than happy with the way that things are going and the way that things are just ticking along nicely. Like I say, there's not millions of fish there, there's not millions of indications, but there's regular indications. And when they're of the size of the fish that we've caught, you don't need hundreds and hundreds of fish. 20 to 25 fish all told, bearing in mind we had a few shallow as well, and you're well on your way to a match winning weight. Well, here we are coming towards the end of the session. We've had 27 or 28 fish. Really has been good. It just goes to show that not just here at Gull Valley, but at other places, you don't need to pile baiting in the edge all the time. It's just worth keeping an eye on the people that are doing well and seeing how they're feeding, because that's how I noticed here. Some people weren't piling baiting and doing really well in the edge. As far as the shallow method's concerned, again, it's not widely used here at Gull Valley, but on a lot of other commercials, it really is the way. And like I've said two or three times, it's really about keeping your work rate high. And like I've said, quite often if you're not getting bites or indications, it's because you're not working hard enough, you're not feeding, you're not rotating your rig. So really be mindful of the fact that you've got to work, work, work. Another thing is, you might see, I'm using red hydro today instead of purple. Again, I'm learning all the time and I'm just upping my elastic. The more I fish, the more I come out and practice, the more matches I fish, the heavier elastic I seem to be using. And the reason I'm on red today is because I've been out a few evenings just practicing, just to see what I can get away with. And you'll notice today how quick I've got some of the fish in. And that is obviously going to speed you up in match conditions. Like I say, just be mindful that you've really got to work hard when you're fishing shallow. And also, when you're fishing in the edge and you're not introducing a big amount of bait, to introduce it regular, because the last thing you want is to have no bait there at all. Little and often will keep bites coming and keep liners and swells to a minimum. And bites, obviously, will be the main thing that you're looking for. When your float goes under, when you've not fed a lot of bait, 9 times out of 10, it's a proper bite. And that, at the end of the day, is going to put you a bigger weight in the net. Like I say, it has been working well here and at other fisheries. But again, when you feel like you've got to be positive, be positive. It's all about getting match fit, reading the conditions and reading exactly what's happening. But I hope today that the two methods that I've shown you are definitely going to put you in good stead, and they may well work on your commercial. Well, there we go. There's what we've caught today. 27 or 28 fish. 15 or 16 down the edge and the rest shallow. Just goes to show that you don't need bucketfuls of bait to catch these fish down the edge, and also that the shallow pole will work. We've caught plenty of fish today on everything we've done. It really is a case of keeping your work rate high and your edge peg fed. Even though you're not piling the bait in, just keep it going in little and often.